So who are these premature babies? Premature babies are the ones who develop, as I said, who are gestationally less than 37 weeks of pregnancy. And what are the problems they are seeming to be associated with? As we all know, when a baby is born premature, the more premature the baby, the body organs are more immature. As soon as the baby is born, the baby is to breathe on his own, and that has to be supported by a good, sturdy, well-developed lung, which happens in a mature baby. But the more premature the baby's lungs are not well formed, and they are not able to open up their lungs, and they have therefore difficulty in breathing, their oxygen levels become less, and the baby unfortunately may not survive if not given the right treatments. So these babies need artificial breathing at birth, sometimes they need oxygen at birth, sometimes they need what's called CPAP, respiratory support at birth, to be able to survive the first few days till the baby's oxygenation improves on its own, till the baby's lungs develop on their own. This is a major problem in most premature babies because they are born with this deficiency and they become difficulty in breathing soon after birth. The other things are just like the lungs, the heart, the brain, the kidneys, the intestine, they're all premature in a baby. The more premature the baby, more these things. But then science and treatments and all across the world, developments in the form of neonatal intensive care and newborn care has done so much wonders for these babies that if given the right time, the treatment, and the baby is born in the right place and then the right treatments, these babies, all these complications can be circumvented and these children can grow up into mature adults as we see so many of them today, and they can be very, very productive and very, very kind of contributory members, intelligent members of our society. They are the next generation and probably all of us should aim towards trying to help these babies do well.
Hi, I'm Dr. Gayathri Karthik, Consultant Obstetrics and Gynecology at Manipal Hospital. I was referred this patient with a large tumor in the baby, causing difficulty in the breathing passage. So I was referred this patient because we have handled cases like this before. So we did perform what we call the exit procedure, where we are able to put in a breathing tube into the respiratory passage of the baby while the baby is still attached to the mother and its mother's circulation is still continuing. So we call this the exit procedure, called the extrauterine intrapartum treatment, that is given to babies where we anticipate difficulty in breathing of the baby and a difficulty in putting a tube into the baby after delivery. So we do that while the baby is still having its maternal blood supply and oxygen supply from the mother. So the exit procedure, the extrauterine intrapartum treatment, what we do is for patients, for babies with difficulties in breathing. Now, when does this happen? If there is a tumor in the neck pressing the larynx or the voice box or the trachea, the windpipe, these babies are likely to have difficulty in breathing or in putting in a tube to help them breathe. So in these kind of conditions, these are picked up antenatally by ultrasound and they are referred to us. And so we have a wonderful team of doctors, including the neonatologists and the anesthesiologists, who we work as a team. So we deliver the baby in half. We perform a cesarean, we deliver the head of the baby, and before we deliver the full baby and cut the cord and separate the circulation, what we do is we deliver the baby. So the baby is still attached to the mother, receiving its blood supply and oxygen from the mother.